Do you feel like you're in a box? And no matter how many times you try to break free, the four walls just enclose you? Does your life seem limited, never moving forward? Do you feel stuck? It starts now. Your program, Blessed Hour.
Hello, friends. May God bless all of you as you are watching us here, joining us on the Blessed Hour, that we are here in order to help you. You who have been crying, yes, like this person you are seeing now on the screen, you have been like this, crying because of your pain, your problems, because the trouble that you are facing on your job is too much for you. The problems you are going through regarding your health is escalating and you are losing day by day. The problems you are going through in your marriage, it is terribly affecting your day-to-day life because it's from one extreme to the other. If you really need help, you are going to call us now at 1-888-332-4141. You are going to give us a call right now. If you really need help, you are going to make sure to find the nearest universal church that you can attend today or tomorrow, Friday, for your deliverance. You need help. If you are seriously in need of help, you are tired of suffering, tired of being in pain, tired of the constant failure, you are tired of the curses in your life, let us help you to use your faith for your life to change. Look at these people who learned to use their faith when they received the blessed water. They used their faith. The power of God came to their lives. God wants to do for you as well. Miss Emery, have you been using the blessed water?
Yes, sir.
And what has been the result of doing so?
The result of using the water, I was in a job that I wasn't comfortable. People were being disrespectful. Every day I have headache, just the stress of the job. So one day I decided to take the leap of faith. The pastor always said, when you doing something, just go ahead, no doubt. Just go ahead and do it. One day I decided I'm not going to take this job anymore. So I resigned immediately. And the following day I heard about a job fair, the same type of job that I'm in. So I wake up in the morning, use the water to wash my face. Usually I drink the water, make breakfast, whatever. And I went to the job fair. After I did my interview and everything, the lady said, "You got the job." I said, "Thank you, but I won't be available until the 11th. She said, "That's fine."
So you already have your new job now?
Yes, I have my new job.
Using your faith with the blessed water worked for you?
Yes, it does.
D'Angelo, what God did in your family through your faith using the blessed water?
Bishop, I had my sister that was sick in the Bahamas for a very long time. Mm-hmm. This sickness she had, she had to lose her job. And the bank took the house from her. Every time she called me, she said, I don't know what's going on. My feet getting bigger and bigger. I can't even lift it up. And I say, you know what? Guess what? I cannot serve God. I'm a servant of God for my family to be down like this. And one Sunday I came to the church, you said, use the water. Take this water. Before I drink the water, I say, God, I will drink this water in the name of my sister. I want healing for her. And when I drink the water, after a week, I called her, and she tell me the feet all swollen, go down, and she healed now, and she working right now.
So she's working?
Yes, sir.
She's able to walk?
She able to walk now. The feet come down like normal feet.
And How would it affect you when you heard of her situation?
Her situation was get me down because I have to keep sending money to her because it affect my financial life. Because mm-hmm. of the situation, I have to help her with certain things, help her with our kids mm-hmm. because she couldn't work.
Okay. But now that problem is solved.
That everything is good now.
She's you drank working. The water
yes,
thinking about her.
Yes, sir.
And you are here in Florida, your sister in Bahamas.
In the Bahamas, yes, sir.
Received the miracle there.
Yes, sir.
Your problem is not that the devil is greater than your faith. No, the devil is not greater than your faith. The problems are not greater than your faith. Your problem is not that you are weak. No. Listen. You have one of these, yes? Yes, you have there on your bed. You opened it there on your bed in Psalm 27, Psalm 35, Psalm 91. You have it on your bed. The problem is that you don't know what is written in the Bible. The problem is you don't know how to use what is here. You don't know how to make what is here to leave the pages of the Bible and enter into your life. As you saw the testimony there of the angel, he said, I cannot accept that I'm a servant of God and my family is in suffering. No, I don't accept. That's the first step for change when you tell yourself, I don't accept to continue suffering. I don't accept. I refuse. If you want a change, my friend, in a few minutes, right after this, I'm going to pray for you. Because you need a strength, you need help. You no longer want to be the person carrying the Bible, having the Bible, knowing the Bible, but your life is messed up. Let us help you to see a real change in your life. We're going to pray for you right now. You can call us at 1-888-332-4141 to place your name in the book of prayer, to place the names of family members, and prepare yourself because this Sunday morning, 10 a.m., you have the opportunity for you to come and see the power of God at work in your life. Because, my friend, it is not for you to continue suffering. If you accept your problems as they are, you don't need to do anything. You can even turn off, go to another video if you want. But if you are serious, you really need help. You want your life to change. So, therefore, stick with me right after this. I'll be back to pray for you. Let us now talk to God. My Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, I have here right now a bottle of the water placed upon your word because whatever is blessed in prayer, whatever is presented in prayer to you becomes holy. And I bless this water because my Father, on this Sunday morning at 10 a.m. when this person comes and receives a bottle of this blessed water, when they use their faith as they will be taught, their lives must change because suffering is not from you, my Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Holy Spirit, I bless those who are right now fed up, tired, cannot take anymore. They don't accept anymore the suffering. My Lord, I rebuke that the spirit of infirmity, that the spirit of curses, that the spirit of stumbling blocks in the ways, I command that negativity right now to get out of this person's life and never more return. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Receive now strength for you to fight against the problems and overcome through faith. My friends, this coming Sunday morning as well, I invite you, bring a loaf of bread. Bring a loaf of bread this Sunday, the 11th, 10 a.m. I'm going to bless the bread for you because I believe in the power of multiplication. Do you? If you believe that God multiplies, God is a God to multiply your success, multiply your prosperity, multiply the health in your life, bring with you a loaf of bread this Sunday morning. I will bless the bread for you and be sure you and your family will eat and be blessed. God himself says that he will bless your bread. Therefore, don't miss out on this opportunity. My address is 2647 North State Road 7. I'm between the Family Thrift Store and the Tire Kingdom. And I'll be waiting for you this Sunday morning to help you. We're open every day. We have other locations, and you can get information of those locations by visiting our website, universalusa.org. This has been your show, The Blessed Hour. We thank you for being with us. Be blessed always. Bye-bye.